things in my life have never been quite good, because I remember when I was born, I got raised first with my dad. Then one of my brother's uncle also chipped in that, and we became a family. That was in early 20, that is in 20s, 2021, 2001 and 2002, 2003. I didn't know anything by that time, but I was quite a kid, a junior. And through that is when one day I got to realize that my mom died, passed some years back, long time ago, when I was young. So I didn't got that love from my mother. Motherly love, I didn't got it well, because each and every time I could ask my dad, where's my mother? And I could never be told where she is. So nikazoea pole pole to be in that kind of environment. Then from there is when I reached, by that time kulikuanga na akuwa na IPP1 ya CBC. Ilikuanga ni lower class, middle class and upper class. So reaching lower class, middle class is when my dad decided to marry another woman who raised me up to where I am. I'm proud of that, because she's still a mother, despite calling her stepmother, but she's still the mother who raised me that level. So life wasn't easy when we were in Nakuru, because my dad was a lecturer by that time at Jogo College. So I think when life started to become difficult, we could sometimes lack food. And my dad could really get drunk too much. So you find the environment was not that conducive whereby he could manage to maintain us as a family by that time. So reaching 2006, 2007 is when now my journey started back in the village, whereby now we shifted back to the village, Siaya County, in a small village known as Mudhiro, Iro Mudhiro, around Sidindi. That's when I started. Now my school in Nakuru ended like that. So I had just to go back to the village, start it afresh in that place. So when I went there, I was enrolled in a primary school known as Mudhiro Primary School. And that's where I started schooling. I remember now mambo ya kuvaa viatu hakuna, hasa ni kuchapa miguu. Na ile mambo ya mkate, chai, sasa ikaisha. Hakuwa na mambo kama hiyo. So remember this time we left my dad in Nakuru telling us that he will come. But it went some years I never saw my dad.
So uko nyumbani just went there.
Me and my mother and my grandmother and my other siblings. So by that time my brother was at the age of around 6-7. So he was still young, you can imagine, because he got class 5 year alikuwa miaka ngapi hiyo. So it was not easy, because life in the village, being accepted there also with that kind of life, it was not really easy for me. But George Nondi struggled a lot in the village, because I remember maisha nakutawa na kuna kulima. So mimi nikaambiwa lazima nifanye nini, niingie shamba. So kuingia shamba ni unarauka asubuhi, before utoke, unuingie shamba, nakumbuka Mabon Town. So hata kushika jembe ilikuwa shida. But something painful it was like, nilikuwa napigwa ngana hizo mawe. That time ground was hard. So unapigwa, unagongwa na unaambiwa lazima ulime. But to me, I take it positive, because it taught me how even to overcome such kind of life. Because wanasemanga, kama wewe ni wa kwanza, firstborn, wanazoea kuzua kwa that kind of environment. So that's how it started. We could lack food sometimes, and I remember kulala chini, sometimes I could sleep down. Si kwa rahisi, mamangu, my stepmother didn't see that kind of love by that time, because when I was in the village with her. So kuzoea hiyo maisha nyumbani ilikuwa ngumu sana, ngumu. Unarauka 5, unaenda shamba, unangangana, unaenda kwa shule na watu huko, alafu Kijaluo ndio ilikuwa inaongelewa sana. So unapata engaging in that kind of language ilikuwa inanishinda. So unapata sometimes even kwa na marafiki ilikuwa ngumu. But I really thank God, because I got one of the friends when we were learning, when we were schooling, when at least pia alikuwa from town. so he can motivate. Oh, kumbe mtu watano pia anaweza kuja asome shule mm. ushago. Mm. Na sasa hiyo ni vumbi miguu tupu. Then eventually maisha ika tukangangana hivyo. Then nikapitia mateso whereby I could run away from our home going to where to my grandmother, mama ya mamangu mzazi now in the western part. Mm-hmm. So hapo nilikuwa nakimbia na toroka huku because huku sioni upendo. Na fitina ilikuwa nyingi ya familia, kuna achiliwa tu,